In reserve for the school. America. That is what this part is. That is what it is. That's something that they are on a side with the students. As long as the struggle has begun, and what we want to say is that this is a strike that we're fighting for the students that San Francisco deserves.
Thank you. And go harder to close. of every campus that is criminal. How many students have been shut out? How many classes have been canceled? How many communications have been not understood? I think that that is an act of authority. I wish the administration would be that ballsy around dealing with this issue and not always make the teachers the villain. I don't know if you saw the text that went out, but they had the nerve to say that it was the teachers who were making the campuses unsafe. I'll tell you what makes campuses unsafe: ignorance and classism.
I mean, we could put somebody on top of the truck, couldn't we?
Federation. generation of teachers. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for coming out today. Earlier we were chanting, "Who are we?" and people were responding, "AFC." Well, I want to correct that, even though I'm from AFC. Who are we? We're City College.
City College.
This is about City College. This is about the city of San Francisco, and this is a proxy fight for the workers of San Francisco, the people of San Francisco, and the city of San Francisco. We're asking for a small increase over 10 years ago. Have the CEOs of San Francisco had no increase for 10 years?
No.
Have the tech industry had no increase over 10 years?
No.
This is a proxy fight for the people of San Francisco. Who are we?
CEOs.
Who are we?
CEOs.
And we need to demand a raise for our teachers. It's a priority for this city to educate the people of this city. And that's a priority. We need to put our money where our priority is at. We need to demand this, and we need to shut it down, which we did. We shut the City College down today. Great job. Who are we?
City College.
Who are we?
City College.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We've had so much support from our labor brothers and sisters today. And next up, we've got Lita Blank from UESF, the K-12 union here in San Francisco.
Yay! Good afternoon, everybody. Right up to my mouth. Okay, there we go. So this morning's Chronicle had a funny headline. It said, "Chanting alleviates urban stress." So I'm guessing all you guys are feeling much less stressed than you were this morning. I am here on behalf of UESF, United Educators of San Francisco. Our 6,000 members stand strong with you. Paraprofessionals, teachers, security guards, librarians, we know that your fight is our fight, because our students, when they graduate from middle school and high school, where do they go?
City College!
Together with our community members.
Next up, we've got a leader from La Voz Latina, which is a Tenderloin neighborhood group. It's one of the organizers involved in the Central City Coalition for Public Education. They've been fighting for this campus, for the Civic Center campus. Yeah.
Guatemala. I live in San Francisco. I've been glad to work with Civic College for 2 years. I work on the Voz Latina and the Tenderloin as a leader. I believe that the teachers are important in the Civic College because without teachers, we will be no teaching, and without students, no learning. The Voz Latina is with the ASC 21 faculty, and the students, we are part of the border fighting to preserve opportunities for all San Francisco who needs to access education.
Right.
First generation, low income students, immigrants, veterans, displaced workers, all who have benefited from quality, affordable education.
Okay.
A 26% cut will hurt students, preventing from them taking classes that they deserve. Por 2 años. Trabajo en la Voz Latina como líder de la comunidad de Tenderloin. Yo creo que como los maestros, como los estudiantes, son importantes. Los maestros, sin maestros no hay enseñanza y sin estudiantes no hay aprendizaje. Yo creo en la igualdad de los derechos. La Voz Latina está con el AFT 2121. Maestros y estudiantes, nosotros formamos parte del comité que pelea y preserva las oportunidades de los sanfranciscanos que necesitan las educaciones, primeras generaciones, estudiantes de bajos recursos, inmigrantes, veteranos, trabajadores desplazados, a todos aquellos que se benefician con la calidad de educación accesible. Un recorte de 26% afectará a los estudiantes y no podrán tomar las clases que ellos se merecen. When I say city, you say college. City!
College!
City!
College!
City!
College!
Woo!
Thank you. I teach ESL, and I've got to say, to come up here in front of a huge crowd and speak in a language that's not your own takes a lot of courage.
I'm also part of the CCS. My name is Ocean. I'm going to try to project as hard as I can. So basically, I'm part of the CCSS Solidarity Committee as well, being at State. So basically, I just came here on behalf and was asked to bring knowledge to the hunger strikers there on Valencia and 16th. And even though they couldn't be here, they're here in spirit. Right, and I spent the last couple of days with them and understand that they're the solidarity that's happening, the community that's happening, and the heart that's happening is all happening right now. And I feel like this is just an extension of everything that's happening inside the community. And the attack on the people of color is not just an attack on an academic level, but on a personal level in private and public sector. So that's all I have to say. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, Ocean, for your courage also. Okay, next up we have an instructor from this campus, from the Civic Center campus, who also has been an incredible advocate for this college and our students, Vanette Cook. Where's Vanette?
Teachers, I lost my sign. So I know I
would talk to you, especially to the language learners that are here today. I know there are many language students here at Civic Center. We start with the very beginning. That's called literacy, where people don't even know the alphabet. And we go up until students like the one who's coming after me who's speaking English very beautifully and very well. So I want them to learn three words today, and I have them printed out for you. And I want them to try to go home with these three words so that they learn something here today from listening to all of us. And the first thing I want to say to all of us is, let's remember that every single day we are alive. We are learners and we are teachers. You are here teaching each other and we are all here learning. So, especially for my language students, but for all of us, what are we learning here today? We are learning that we believe in supporting democracy and supporting education. We are here to stand up and speak when it's difficult, when maybe we are asked to be quiet and to wait and take our turn later. But we are here now saying we want to be listened to today. So for my students, if you are here, everybody can pronounce this first word. So the first word is the word fair. Would everybody please shout out?
Never give up.
Never give up. And show respect and do legal to ask for respect in a democracy. This is a democracy. We are legal to be here. Thank you. And could everybody please say, thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming.
And if you feel like it, turn to the person nearby you, to your left, to your right, and say, thank you for coming here today.
Thank you for coming here today. Thank you for coming.
Jessica Buxbaum, and I'm the MC today, and I just want to say that